Hello. So we saw that black has no problems in the line with knight e5. Let's try to transpose into the main lines of the Karakhan defense for white. e4, c6, d4, d5, knight c3, d, knight e4, bishop f5, knight g3, bishop g6, h4, h6, knight f3, e6, h5, bishop h7, bishop d3, bishop d3, queen d3, knight f6. So the critical move is bishop d2. This video is about bishop f4 and other side lines. Sometimes white plays knight e5, knight bd7, f4. Well, I think that in that particular position, black can play queen b6, and I see no way for white how to castle long. So in the game, white tried knight d7 and king d7, very good move. Black just wants to castle by playing rook d8 and king c8. c4, bishop b4, bishop b2, rook d8, castles long, king c8, with an equal position. So knight e4. Now we should really take queen e4 and play queen d5. That's the usual stuff for the Karakhan defense. To exchange the knight, play queen d5. And white has no edge. Queen d3, for example, knight d7, bishop d2. b5 was played, b3, bishop b7, c4, bc, bc, and queen d6. Very old game by Grandmaster Bagirov with black. Queen d5, cd, bishop f4, knight c6. It's just an equal position. Also, white can try queen e2, knight d7. If now c4, and queen a5, king f1, and bishop e7 is in equal position. So bishop d2, trying to castle long. We castle long also. c4, queen f5, castles long. Bishop d6 with the idea of playing bishop to f4. Bishop e3. Black changes the strategy. Black wants to play e5. Knight f6, queen c2, queen c2, knight c2, knight g4, rook hf1, rook e8, bishop d2, everything is ready, and just e5. Zakhanovich Ratkovich, 2017, with an equal position. So, really, these moves are not critical. Let's talk about bishop f4. So, now I will explain why we play e6 on the 7 move. If we play knight d7, h5, bishop h7, bishop d3, bishop d3, queen d3, e6, bishop f4, queen a5, bishop d2, bishop b4. That's the line, c3, bishop e7, c4, and queen c7. It's a complex position. Objectively speaking, white has no advantage. White sometimes plays d5. It's a forced, I think it can be called forced draw after d5. Why not to skip this theory by playing our move order? Because now, if white plays bishop f4, we just play bishop d6, and it's zero problems for black already. Let's try some moves. Once white tried rook h4 in the correspondence game, but I don't see much point. Bishop f4, rook f4, queen d6, knight e5, knight d7, knight e4, knight e4, rook e4. Queen b4, queen c3, queen c3, bc, knight e5, rook e5, castles on rook d1. Okay, it was a draw. Everything was changed. So, two another moves. Knight e5. We just take on e5, and after bishop e5, you should know the idea already. Queen a5. White now cannot castle long. If now queen d2. Queen d2, king d2, knight bd7, rook h4, knight e5, d, rook d8, king e2, knight d7, rook e4, knight c5, rook e3, and king e7. That was a correspondence game. The position is equal. So c3, knight bd7. Now white should play carefully. I think that maybe already white made some commitment. Bishop f4, for example, castles, bishop d2, c5, c4, queen c7, dc, knight c5, queen e2, rook d8. That was one game. The internet, black is slightly better already. due to beta piece activity. So f4, castle slow, queen e2. But the problem is that bishop is now exposed after knight e8. It's a game, white tried a4, but after f6, just piece up for black. So knight e4 is only move. f6, bishop d6, f5, bishop b4, queen d5, knight g3, knight c7, protecting against bishop e7, castles, Yermenkov against Filipenko, and here black should have played knight f6, and black is just better because look at all this g4, e4 squares. Disaster for white. So bishop e5, it's a better try because it's an equal position. Bishop e5. Now knight e5, I think that queen a5 is playable in that position, but much easier to play knight bd7. If now f4, then already queen a5 is a move. Queen d2, queen d2, king d2, rook d8. That was equal position, but c3 is bad move because rook d8, queen e2, castles. And now b4, it's already a big mistake. Queen a3, queen c2, knight d5, knight e2, knight takes e5, f takes e5, and f6, Collins again power, and white was in big trouble. So castles is better try, but c5, Pelletier against Dreyev, and black was better. So castle alone, queen a5, knight d7, and here black should have played king d7 with a similar idea in one of the lines, because black doesn't want to give up e4 square for the knight. Can be one rook a8, just quick king c8, it's just harmless equal position for white. D is critical because after queen d3, cd, knight d5, knight e4, black should know the cold blooded move knight d7. And of course white can't win now the pawn, knight d6, king d7, knight b7, but after rook hb8, knight a5, rook b2, knight c6, king f8, castles, and rook c8, black is fantastic compensation for the sacrifice pawn. Of course white cannot take on a7 because after rook c7 white loses a knight. So d4, but then black plays king d7. That was a game between two engines. I think black has no problems in the end game. So the only move remaining is the most popular move: bishop takes d6, queen takes d6, and in one correspondence game, I tried knight e4, knight e4, queen e4. But the problem with that move order is that queen b4. Nasty check. C3, queen b2, castles, knight d7, rook b1, queen c3, rook b7, knight f6, queen b1, castles, rook c1. And the draw was agreed, but I think after queen a3, knight f5, rook a8, knight c6, and rook d7, black has no problems at all. And in the practical game, white has some problems with the h5 and a2 pawns. So, castle long, knight bd7, and king b1 is the main move. For example, rook h1, castles, knight e5. So we saw similar positions already. Now black just wants to play c5 at some point. So for example, rook d8, f4, Van Riems deck against Sansegude. Here black should have played queen c7, queen f3, and c5. I think the position is equal. For example, c4. When you see the move c4, you should be happy because white made some commitments on the queen side. Castles, rook h1, rook fd8, knight e4, knight e4, queen e4, knight f6, and black was slightly better in the correspondence game. Polgar tried queen e2 now, castles, knight e5, queen c7, rook h1, but I think that white can play without playing queen e2. Rook d8, now knight e4, knight e4, queen e4, then the easiest way of playing for black is just to take on e5, d, and to exchange rooks. And I think that white's space advantage is nothing in this position. So f4 was played, c5, dc, knight, c5, Polgar, Ivanchuk. I think that black has really no problems. So king b1, just waiting move, preparing knight e4 and protecting the a2 pawn. Castles. Well, black can castle long, but I don't like such positions because after a long castling, black has no clear plan. And then white knight goes to e5, attacking the f7 pawn. So in such positions, you should castle short. Knight f4, Queen e4, Knight f6, Queen e2, Rook fd8, all normal moves. After Knight f5, c5, it's already good move. Dc, Queen c5, g4, and Rook a8. So what's the point? Black just wants to play Knight d5 next. For example, if f4, continuing the attack, then Knight d5, and Black's idea is to play Rook d6, Rook b6, and Black's attack is faster. So c4, it's a good move, protecting against Knight d5. Black plays a6, trying to play b5 maybe. And now if f3, it's an easy game for Black after Queen c7, Rook h1, take on d1, Rook d8, f4, Knight e4, good move. A3, because if Rook d8, Queen d8, Queen e4, then Queen d1 mate. But then f5 came, gf, ef, Marjanovic Kompora, and Black had no problems. So f4, it's an aggressive approach, Rook d4, and it's a pattern against Magem. White played Queen f3, Knight e4. White is already in trouble, but King c2, it was just a losing move because after f6, White loses everything. So g5, hg, and now if fg, then knight f4, rook d4, queen d4, knight f3, and queen c4, and Black is just winning. So h6, but now White should be really creative to make a draw. Hg, rook takes h6, rook takes f4, because White is 2 pawns down, and the only way to make a draw is rook hg1, king g7, and rook h7. It's a pity, but it's a perpetual check because Black cannot play king f8 due to knight d7, so it's a draw. But I think that this line shows that White really should be careful in such positions when they start the attack, because Black's play with c5 is too quick when having not much pieces on the board. So let's make some conclusions about this line. Well, we saw another moves, but bishop f4 was the main subject of this video, and Black just plays bishop d6 because the knight is on b8 and not on d7, exchanging the bishop, and I think that bishop d6 is the most precise move, otherwise White can have some troubles. So in the next video I'll talk about another move, bishop d2. So see you again soon. Goodbye.